This is a small cassette recorder from Norelco in 1970 or 71. It was for $100 and it was the executive model. This one is just to sort of show the type, because cosmetically and functionally it's a disaster and should be put out of its misery if I was kind. But we'll make a short video with whatever we can about it. Came with a remote mic. Had capabilities for line. Had an earphone. Speaker here. Battery meter. This is an automatic level control, so that's not a level meter. Wrist strap and the back. Now, when I got this, it was as non-working, and there's many, many reasons it wasn't, although I got it to work a little bit. First place, there was absolutely no screws in it, so the back just sort of lifts off, which makes some part easier anyway. And there's a lot of corrosion in the battery compartments. I had to put a couple pieces of metal down in there. And somehow, the entire power adapter that would normally be there is missing. And you can see the leads here. And they were wrapped around a little idler wheel down there so the thing wouldn't play. So I sort of temporarily taped those in, and the batteries won't stay in there without tape, so it's pretty much a disaster. And the buttons, trial and error has shown me, have to be pressed from the back. If you press them from the front, not much happens and they get stuck. But pressing them from the back, it looks a little weird, but they do release. And fast forward does work and rewind does work. But a very strange thing is the volume. The volume is very, well, it's missing at first for about 5 or 10 seconds, no matter what you do. And then it comes in very good. But then let's say I press stop, rewind, and then play again. It's going to take another 5 or 10 seconds for the volume to start. It's almost, obviously there's a capacitor issue somewhere. But it reminds me a little bit of an old tube system. But this is worse because it constantly needs to re-warm up. And let's see, what else is wrong with it? Well, you name it, it's wrong with it. Here's the instruction manual that came with it. Pretty common instructions. One thing I think happened was the person got this rechargeable battery, and I think they messed everything up with that. And I'll show you why in a second. There's some of the specifications. Back to the rechargeable battery. This came with it. Let's follow the wire here. Follow the wire. Oops, where'd it go? It looks like we've got some type of odd, poorly spliced job. Let's keep following it, and then it terminates in this. Not quite sure what that's supposed to be, but obviously they used the rechargeable battery and did some sort of long-term damage in here or something, and they ended up cutting the power cords. I'm not 100% sure. So the unit deserves to be dead, but it's not dead. I've also found out it won't play anything over a 60-minute tape. It won't play a 90-minute tape or a 120-minute tape. It needs a thicker tape, I guess. Let's try a little recording and playback. can see the heads there. When the volume will start, we'll find out. Of course, this wasn't designed for music. Try a recording. All right, it came with a small microphone with a remote. And I have to remember that even when recording, there would be no volume if I started talking right away, and it'll play back. There wouldn't be anything there for however long. All right, this is the Norelco 1440 executive cassette recorder from about 1970. Sold for $100. This particular one is a disaster all over. But I got it working a little bit, and at least it'll be good to show as a type of this recorder. So, has lots of problems. Buttons don't work well. Batteries aren't great. House power's gone. Volume's wacky. Cosmetically, it's a disaster. But other than that, I like it. Executive cassette recorder from about 1970, sold for $100. This particular one is a disaster all over, but I got it working a little bit, and at least it'll be good to show as a type of this recorder. So, has lots of problems. Buttons don't work well. Okay, really, once the volume got going, it doesn't sound that bad. For all its issues, it doesn't make a half bad voice recording. So that's the Norelco 1440 executive cassette recorder from about 1970. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching.